So I think I understand the first critique, but I don't quite understand why the F is neoliberal. Can you explain that?
Lots of reasons. So first of all, the orientation of the F framework is a link because it focuses on the individual and how they relate to ethics, which is a neoliberal project.
Wait, why? As opposed to what?
As opposed to recognizing the way that capitalism structures the way that people view
why
and interact with the world.
I don't see why
because
those are.
Because we say that an individual focus is one that is neoliberal and shuts down our ability to create coalitions.
So when we don't focus on the individuals, why do people matter anymore?
We focus. I don't understand what
that
is.
Why do people matter if we don't focus on the individuals?
We say that capitalism reduces people's lives to almost nothing because it structures.
So why don't we use ethics to reformulate the mattering of individuals?
Because they don't matter right now. We say that capitalism structures their world, so it's.
So why can't we use the ethics to make them matter now? It seems like this is a problem with the SPLO, which I don't defend.
That wasn't the only link. I can go through all the ones
specific
to the free speech. So the second link is about communicative capitalism, which talks about how we use speech as like a commodity and trigger into a broader system of capital where we're just like, yeah, if we talk about something, we talk about it enough, suddenly everything will be fixed and deliberation is great. Because you treat it like a commodity.
Where are we assigning a dollar value or any kind of value to speech itself?
Because the whole point of the one is
so
that
by saying that I value my life and I value TJ's life and I value your life, am I being
speech
capitalist?
Assigns an inherent
you
value
do I have a question.
To speech.
By saying I value myself and I value TJ and I value your life,
we say that
is that capitalist?
We say that capitalism makes those, like,
my question is, can't we value anything without being capitalist?
That's our argument, isn't that, hey, I care about how you're capitalist. That's not what the argument is.
So it's not just that we value something. It's more.
Yes.
What?
Okay,
I think your articulation of the language shows
you
value
keep
speech.
Interrupting me.
Okay, keep going.
Okay, awesome. So, that's what I wanted. So, let's talk about, like, the fetishization of speech, which is what the Dean card talks about, is that you view it as an end in and of itself. You treat it as a commodity that can be used. It also emphasizes the individual against society, as opposed to emphasizing a community against capitalism.
Does anyone pay for speech?
That's
like, it seems like commodities are inevitable. Like, anytime you eat food, you're engaging in commodities.
I mean, we say that's a linkage to the cap critique, and also capitalism.
So,
like, an analysis of neoliberalism isn't just like, this is money, and this is money, and this is money. It's something way broader than that, and the field is, like, diverse, and this is the field, like, this field.
I just don't get why we can't have a commodity and still not be capitalist. Like, commodities exist in anarchy where there's no system of exchange, right? Like, toilet paper is a commodity. Food's a commodity.
Our argument would be that we wouldn't value them in the same way that
Why?
We do in a capitalist system.
We value them because they're useful to us. I don't
see
how that changes without
capitalism.
Yeah, that's
a way of thinking about something.
What's, okay.
I mean, that would be like a link into our critique, to value something only as
so
a useful
So how do you think about food? Do you value it as an end in itself or because it brings you to the end of staying alive?
Our argument is that you shouldn't value things just based on their usefulness in a way that you treat them like a commodity.
Then what? Some things are just objects.
That
I don't see how we have to. Do we have to value food as an end in itself?
We say that it structures the way that you view humans and other like beings in the world, which causes mass death, oppression. It causes us to dehumanize people. It makes the pursuit of ethics impossible because it structures the way that people relate to the world and the world relates to people.
Thank you.
247 prep budget.
Can you come talk?
Almost all the 1 hours are staffed by youth access stuff that you need. So it's going to be starting on the AC underview one. Then we'll go up top to the Markovitz analysis, top down from there, and the K's know that they were red. I'll be addressing the spikes thing on the underview extension, if that's okay. Very good. And you ask for new new responses to AC spikes and AC spikes extensions, and that might be okay if the implications are not clearly in the AC, but the extension of Jackson and Parker was there in the AC. It explicitly says in the app that the negative is not get any fiat for counter advocacies, including K alternatives. This is laughable. She conceded it extend the actualism under actualism is a metaethical view that whether you ought to do A depends on whether A would be better than whether you would actually do it if you do not do A. Not whether there's some better action available. They can see multiple more in CG. They can see the actualism corresponds to the advice we give other agents, then it falls from the obligation not to cause harm. The implication was super clear in the AC. This means the neg does not get fiat for counter advocacy. Takes out the critique alternative, means the second op goes away. There's no credence here. She won a quarters bid. She does not need credence. Additionally, this is uniquely good. I am not abstract. I'm talking about how we focus on whether whiteness will actually take an action. We recognize the professor procrastinating will not take an action. Therefore, we do not expect him to do so. This is the least abstract and necessarily takes out the alternative. Also, a necessary turn to the other thing because she, to the other critique because she is the one abstracting away from discussions. The other problem is that she is conceding almost the entirety of the avenue. She only has one turn. Let's go to it. I am agreeing that racism is bad, but my argument was that she needed to impact it back to the app and weigh it against the app, none of which she does because she does not answer the affirmative. Let's go to the Markovitz analysis. You've extended that no individual ever has a point of epistemic judgment that is valuable in and of itself. Rather, they are or the epistemic value that is in the abstract always better than every individual has a few implications. The first is that the affirmative uniquely is a rare articulation by which we value individuals as essence themselves. They produce discourse. That in an end is really something that contributes to ethics as a whole. Both can be valued as ends in and of themselves. Now let's go to the third argument for why we prefer this standard. It is quite good to delinks me from the first critique. Only the critique is only the KAC adapts from away from moral atrocities, which we know we have extended 300 years ago. We thought slavery was good and it was the norm, which means that the AC is adaptive. I am not abstract. I'm talking about how white people are racist and we need to recognize that. Sadly, they have a vote too, and we are living in a Trump administration. We cannot keep kidding ourselves. Let's go to the contention. The anger analysis is laughable. It is talking about government intervention. That is the negative world. The negative world is one in which the government constantly comes in and tells us what speech we can and cannot have, which means the marketplace of ideas is bad, but that is only in the negative world, which means that is the problem with the negative. She's also conceded almost the entirety of the contention, and the contention is quite good. First, she's conceded the affirmative has 100% risk of stopping genocide, which is going to be outweighing both of the critiques. That is the paper analysis of the AC is a world in which we weed out viral ideologies. Also takes out the links because it shows the AC is a world in which the links do not happen because viral ideologies are appearing. The problem is the negative world is one which we silence speech, and only the only people that are able to talk are people like Trump, who braids Democrats at all times, which means everyone continues to live in the world of shams. Now let's go to the Greenwald analysis. You can extend it. The negative is actively oriented against truth, means she cannot turn the affirmative. It also means that I always outweigh because she has conceded epistemic validity outweighs, and she has conceded that only I have a risk of epistemic validity. Let's go to the critiques. On the first critique turn, this is obviously false. I am justified by past injustices. Crossify the third word from the AC. Second argument, you can turn it. The negative ignores history by forgetting injustice, that not everyone agrees that racism is bad. Sadly, the KKK has a vote, and they are part of the reason we have a Trump presidency, which means that you ignore history. I didn't do that. We live in a world that is racist. The third argument is you can turn it. The affirmative analyzes genocide in a historical sense and analyzes how we can stop it. That is the Pinker analysis. Also, let's go to the Hedley analysis. Sadly, the KKK has
has a vote, so we're people of color, maybe may not care about them, but society does. The second argument is affirmative is an ideological shift by which we value individuals in a different way. Then I'm gonna second first, the affirmative does not value speech in the abstract, rather it criticizes restrictions. The second argument is turn that the affirmative uniquely communicates the value of people. That is the Marxist analysis. The third argument is these are problems with the status quo, because the status quo treats everything as a commodity, not individuals as people, whereas AC is a rearticulation. The fourth argument is we can value something without it being a commodity, i.e. without it being a commodity, i.e. speech does not have to be a commodity, that just because we value it, I do not treat India as a commodity, and I value her life. The fifth argument is that we can have commodities without being capitalist. Even in a world that is not capitalist, we still have food and we treat it as a commodity because it's something that is not an end in itself. Let's not kid ourselves, it's an object.
I did not read any of that.
Capitalism causes racism, the one you see, and so it's conceded literally five links to the past.
front and then take it off. So your extension, what are the five words? There are five. I didn't really hear five. I wonder what they are.
Okay, cool. So the first one is that the 1AC misdiagnoses the problem. It's an economic problem and not a problem of repression. The second one is like a fetishization of speech valorizes the individual and struggles against dominant structures. The third is that the 1AC jumps to quick legalistic solutions or quick like reorientations that stop a struggle against capitalism. The fourth is
how does he all differ from that? Isn't they all just like a quick epistemological or reorientation?
No.
What is the alt then? You said the alt looks like a community-based approach and is an epistemological reorientation. Quoting you there. And you just said reorientations are bad.
Yeah, those were pretty good words. So our argument is that when you like reject like the notion of capitalism, you work antithetical to it. So you adopt new value systems. And this is like a gradual approach. We're not just like, let's all become communes and suddenly we'll like hold hands and kumbaya. Our argument is that you have to like take a, like a first step of rejecting capitalist ideologies that structure universities and the way that we view the landscape, which is what all of our links criticize the 1AC for doing. Then we can move on to like revolutionary praxis. We can value people as like as people in and of themselves. We reject like the orientation towards commodities, things like that. There's a fifth link argument. Did you want it? Okay, yeah. So the fifth link argument is that the 1AC's like orientation towards philosophy and abstracting from material conditions is one that's uniquely bad.
Sounds a lot like the first critique that you can see three link trees to.
Sounds like a critique that was Kondo. So
it's not an alt. It obviously can't be Kondo.
Know.
Okay,
so,
that's fine. I know where I'm going. 2AR. It's going to start first critique, AC, second critique. Yeah, the AC will be talking about Jackson Kirker. First critique, like material realities, abstraction stuff, then AC, then the second. On this AC, I'll be starting on Markowitz. It'll be the same round as the one. I'll make it clear when I'm at.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
First off, AC, second off. Everyone good? The 2NR opened up with racism is the biggest impact, then we heard nothing about racism for the remainder of the 2N. Too bad I have three link turns on the racist ad that she does not talk about. Let's go to them. She has conceded that the AC is the one which we are uniquely not racist because we are uniquely acknowledging past injustices, i.e. that slavery was the reality 300 years ago. That was a link turn. The second argument is the negative, ignores history by forgetting the injustice that not everyone disagrees that agrees that racism is bad. And the third argument is really good, that the app analyzes genocide in history, so it is obviously not abstract. She's conceded the app is the least possible abstract world, that the app is the one which we reject racism, and we hear nothing from her in the 2N other than that racism is important, but the app is the only one with that impact. Let's go to the app. There are a few things that are very important. The first is the Markowitz analysis that is conceded out throughout the entirety of the round. She has conceded that this takes out the second link, because I do not link it whatsoever to the capitalism critique, because I have the unique value of individuals as ends in themselves, because no individual isn't in and of themselves the only person, but rather each individual ends in part of a collective, which means every individual is reoriented. Obviously, I have a reorientation. That is how an alternative or a framework works, which means that I get to have an orientation. She has also conceded that epistemology is the greatest layer, which means I always that way, because she has conceded the Moose analysis. That only the AC has epistemological reorientation. She cross-applies anchor to her critique, but she has conceded the term that the negative is the world of government intervention. It is the one that has restrictions and actively tells us when we can or cannot talk, which means the affirmative only doesn't work in the negative world. Then there are a few things that take away from the critiques. The first is the Pinker analysis, which she concedes is uniquely shown that the affirmative is a world in which we do not even have the links to begin with, because it weeds out virulent ideologies, because we have a world that vitalizes truth and reaches the
correct ideas, i.e. that racism is bad, but not everyone agrees in the status quo, which means that it's uniquely good. And the other implication is, Pinker, is that the affirmative unit has 100% strength of link of solving the solving genocide, because it is a uniquely world in which we do not have violent ideologies, and we don't have ideological civil war, and we do not have genocide as an empirical analysis, which means AC uniquely outweighs. Now let's go to Jackson and Parker. Her responses are too little, too late. This was in the app. I don't know why she thinks she gets to make too new to it. Our responses extend Jackson and Parker, then takes out the K alternative because no name fiat for counterpoint. She takes out or critique. She says this takes out the affirmative as well because the app is also fiat based. But this argument is specific to the negative because the affirmative is the one with the initial proposition. Go to her second up. This critique does not make any sense because she has conceded a few no links and just extends hers blindly. She spends 5 minutes extending and never interacts with any of my arguments. You can send the affirmative does not value speech in the abstract, but rather criticizes restrictions in and of themselves, which is a D-link because I do not focus on what she says. I do. The second argument is for the affirmative uniquely values the uniquely values individual worth of people. The third, which is the Markowitz analysis, and the third argument is that we can have a commodity without being capitalist, i.e., food is always going to be a commodity even in a capitalist world. So it doesn't matter if speech is a commodity; it's still something that we can value, just not as an end in itself, because it is an object.